Hello, Cliffosaurs. I'm going to tell you a scary story that happened to me. So, when I was doing DoorDash, I used to do DoorDash. And when this one time I had to drop off I had to drop off someone's food, right? And I remember this very vividly, actually. When I pulled up to their home, right, I don't remember what food it was. I think maybe it was like Panda Express. I'm not sure. When I pulled up to their home, it was a house. It was one of those like, I think it was like, I don't know, it's like houses where it's like half half. It was like two like longer, taller houses that were connected together. I don't know if they call them. It's not duplex, but it's kind of like, it's like two thin, like kind of like in Harry Potter, like those two like thinner, taller apartments, like two floors, and then they're like connected to each other, but each half is like a different home, right? I think it was like something like that. And this was in, I think it was in Beaverton, Oregon. It's like a little bit in the suburbs of Oregon. And when I pulled up to their home, I noticed that the lights at the top of the at the t at the second floor of the house was light is lit up. Okay, there was somebody in there, and I just remember seeing that there was this giant, not giant, but like it was like a big, like blanket type of, you know, like when some people put, I don't know, like college kids or whatever, like they put like a sheet. It's like purple, right? It's purple. And it's got like, I don't know, maybe like the signs like Capricorn, Taurus, those things. It was on the wall. I could see through the window. I could see on the wall that there was this, there was a like a blanket or sheet or what. I don't know. It's just like decoration. And in front of it, there was a, I think it was a girl, right? Maybe in her 20s, early 20s to mid 20s. She was sitting by the window, but the curtain was kind of like, it was a bit, you know, it was a bit like closed, but she, like, I remember she was peeking through it, and as soon as I pulled up, she closed it and like kind of hid behind the curtain, and yeah, like she just came, went out of view. Like I just noticed she was looking, and then like she like stopped looking. And she was gone. I was like, oh, I guess she was just checking to see if I was, you know, the foods, her food, her or their food was gonna be there, right? That's normal. Like that, I get that. I don't get that a lot actually, but I, it made sense to me. I was like, oh, she, you know, they probably just wanted to see if they're, if I was about to get there and the food's about to get there. Okay. The driveway though was completely dark. There was one car parked in front of the garage door. Okay, there's a car parked in front of the garage door. And so it's like this, and then the cars are like right here, and there's like a pathway that gets that leads to the front door on the right of it, and just the garage doors right here, and then the two cars right. It was just one car. I don't know if it was one car or two car, but I just remember there's with this car right here. It was very dark, and it, you know, usually there's just nobody in the, there's nobody there, right? Like it's just, I don't see anything. You know, and usually I know that I'm pretty much by myself. I'm alone there. You know, I do night. I do like, I did like dinner shifts. So like I did like nighttime driving. And so I walk up the pathway to the front door, drop off the food, take the picture, yada, yada. I do all the same things that I always do when I'm dropping off food, right? There's nothing new here. There's nothing different. And, but like, there's like a pathway, right, that goes leads to the front door, but there's a wall here because the garage is on this side. And as I walk a back towards my car, right, I'm walking away from the house from the front door because I already took the picture, I sent it, and you know, I did all I'm supposed to do. I'm leaving. As I'm leaving, okay, as I'm leaving, I look at the front of the car. I see in the front, seat of the car that was totally in complete darkness. Okay, there's no headlights, there's no nothing. It's just there's nothing in my mind that said that there would have been somebody in the car. Okay? And as I talk about this, the more crazier like it feels to me. Like, I know like some people think it's like, "Oh, okay, it's not a big deal," but hear me out. Okay? So, as I leave and walk away from the front door, I look at the car and there's somebody sitting in the car, and immediately sent chills down my spine. I have not felt that type of chill before. And when somebody says like a chill down your spine, it wasn't just a chill down my spine. It was just like my whole body knew that there was something fucking off, right? Like, excuse my French, by the way. I just knew something was really off with what I just, you know, with what I was encountering, right? There was a girl sitting in the front seat of the car. Okay, she was sitting in the front seat of the car, and she was looking at, and she was looking out the wind, the front of the car like this. I don't even know what expression I did. I'm replicating the expression that I saw. I saw the girl. She looked out of front, looked through the front of the car at me like this. I was like, what the, like in my head, I was like, what the heck is going on? Like, I did not expect anybody to be there. It looked like it was completely empty. It was completely dark, right? Usually that's what it is. Like, there's nobody in the cars. One time I saw someone put a mask in the front seat, like the headrest of the car. And that scared the shit out of me one time. But it was an actual whole arse girl in there just sitting silently in the dark, staring at me as I was about to leave. I walked quickly back to my car, which was parked on the opposite side of the road that was, opposite of the house that I just delivered my food to. And I was like, as I drove off, I was like, what just happened? That was insane. What just happened? Why was there a girl staring at me smiling in a really creepy way in complete darkness, just sitting there? Like, why is she just sitting there? It's like, it was like 8 or 9 p.m. Like, did she just get home? Is she just chilling in the car for a bit? Like, and someone's told me, like, yeah, sometimes they do that too, but I don't know. It just doesn't seem, I don't know. I feel like the way she looked at me was just so off. Like, and she looked like a normal person. It didn't look like she was unhealthy or anything. She just looked like a normal person. But the smile and the eye contact that she gave me was, it just felt sinister in a way. And I wonder if that day, like, I don't know, if they deemed me right. Like, maybe they were like trying to like kidnap me or, I don't know. Like, I just felt, I don't want to like imagine too far, like what could have happened, but it just, in retrospect, it really creeped me out. But anyway, that's my story. I have other stories, actually, and I'm just about to start unveiling them.